now. A guy was entering his second year with the Yankees. His first year, he did such a great job out of the bullpen, and that is Adam Ottavino. Adam, how you doing?
I'm great. Thanks for having me.
I know shortly you'll head down to Tampa to start pitchers and catchers in spring training. Your thoughts about your team as you go down?
I mean, you got to feel good about it, right? I mean, pretty much same team as last year, plus Garrett. So, you know, feeling great, optimistic. It's going to take a lot of hard work. Nothing's a given, but feel good about it for sure.
You know, we just had Gary here, and, you know, we talked about the last pitch of the season. I'm sure you've read everything. You're not just a baseball player. You're a fan as well. Do you believe that he knew what pitch was coming?
I really don't know. I've watched all the videos, all the Spygate stuff, you know, trying to look at it. It looks a little fishy, but I just don't know. I can't say one way or another.
How much does the idea of it anger you? That's one thing we've heard a lot is you guys all make a living, have to work so hard to play in the big leagues. Does it offend you personally that there are people taking shortcuts?
Yeah, for sure. I just think if it's like a buzzer system, it's just like egregious, obviously. So
what about the trash cans, though?
Yeah, I mean, that's bold. I mean, obviously very, very just bold. I mean, they broke it down. It sounds so obvious. So for me, when the trash cans stop, it makes me think that they just got smarter with the cheating, not that they stopped. So that lends itself to a possible buzzer system. I don't know. But yeah, it's just it's tough. It's a crazy rabbit hole to go down, for sure.
So if it ends up being ill-gotten gain, what would you describe? Disappointed? Angry? Like, how would you feel about missing that opportunity to play in the World Series?
Yeah, disappointed. I mean, I'm not an angry type of person like that, because I still think we could have done things to win the series. I mean, I'm always trying to look at what we could have done. But I think, I'd be disappointed. We were right there. We're making that comeback in that game. We felt like we were going to win that game and then win the next game. So, you know, it ends. It's kind of like shocking that it's over. But, you know, that's how it went.
You know, Don just asked Gary this. I want to ask you. So when Mayu hits that home run, you guys are done. And he hits that home run, and all of a sudden there's life again. And then Altuve hits the home run to win it. Would you have rather LeMayu not hit the home run? Would it have been less painful if you just lost in the top of the ninth inning?
Maybe, but I don't know. It was a great moment when he hit the home run. We were so alive in the dugout. I know me personally, like, I was dying to get back in a game, kept it scoreless, and then we made the comeback, so I was, like, dreaming, like, okay, I'm going to turn it around. The team's going to turn around. We're going to win this thing. So it was a great feeling in the moment, and it was just kind of, like, disbelief when he hit the home run.
Now, we're also joined by Gio Urshela, the Yankee third baseman, and what a year he had last year. Out of nowhere with all the Yankee injuries, he got his opportunity, seized the opportunity, and had an unbelievable season. So, Gio, I'll ask you what I just asked Adam before you sat down. Do you think that Altuve knew what pitch was coming, the last pitch of the year?
Probably. It feels like so confident in that at bat against the best closer in the game, and probably he knew what was coming.
Now, does that make you angry?
A little bit. But we're trying to do the best. We got a really good team. They got a good player, too, but we're trying to do the best and play the baseball clean. The
Yankee fans were so surprised by your year last year. Were you surprised at all on how it came together?
I mean, not really. I always been working for wait a season like this and trying to do my best, and I was waiting for this opportunity, and thanks God come last year.
It's got to be a great feeling, you know, and Duhar's healthy again. And Brian Cashman and Aaron Boone said, well, you know, it's Gio Urshela's job. Did you worry that you were going to have to battle Miguel for that position? But now you're going into spring training, and it's your job to win or lose.
I mean, it's right to be me, to be myself, keep working. We are a family. We work together. For the season, we're going to be together and trying to do the best we can. And wherever they need me, I'll be there, try to help the team.
Adam Betances is now gone. Does your role, or is there more emphasis on your role? How does that change now that he's gone?
I mean, he didn't really play last year. He threw two batters, so I think it'll be the same. You know, things always change every year, so you got to be ready for anything. But, you know, ultimately, we didn't end up having him, so that was disappointing, you know, for him and for us.
You know, a lot of players that I've spoken to, a lot of people in baseball, say that what the Astros are going to have to deal with this year is that players are angry. And there might be people that throw at them. They might be getting into fights as players say, oh, yeah, you took money out of my pocket. Do you see that happening? Could that be a problem with the Astros?
I have no idea. I mean, there are people that'll talk a big game, you know, about all that stuff. I don't know what'll happen in actuality. I know me, I don't like to let guys on base, like, for any reason. So it's hard for me to just start firing balls at people and let free guys get on base, you know, especially in a one-run game or something like that. But I could see a couple people in particular that feel like they were wronged, you know, going for it, and maybe they don't want to dig in so comfortably.
Mm-hmm. Gio, you're from Colombia,
yeah.
And there is a history of Colombian ball players, but not necessarily as much as there are from other countries in Latin America. How big is baseball in Colombia culturally growing up?
It's growing a lot. Like I feel like it's the last couple of years since we went to the World Baseball Classic. It's been growing, and I feel really happy for all the players that is growing, that showing all the teams that we got really good players in Colombia.
You know, I'm interested, Adam. You know, you spent your career with the Rockies before last year with the Yankees. So you had seen Gerrit Cole when he was a Pirate. And then you saw him last year with the Astros. How much different was he with the Astros? And which pitcher do you expect to see with the Yankees?
I think he'll be a lot closer to what he was with the Astros, and he'll probably continue to evolve a little more.
How has he evolved?
Well, I mean, with the Pirates, he was throwing a lot of sinking fastballs, pitching more with, like, a contact philosophy, pitching in a lot. That's the way the Pirates kind of go about it. And once he got with the Astros, he was just throwing four-seamers high, really leaning into his strengths a lot, more breaking balls. Just change up his mix, but same arm, same talent, just different strategy. And you can see how he's really smart, and you can see how over time he, like, kind of figures out what's the next thing he has to get a little better at and prioritize.
I'm wondering, because Yankee fans, when the Yankees signed Gerrit Cole, 9 years, you know, $3 trillion, everybody's excited. Wow, that's great. You're a player on the team. What was your first reaction when you hear, wow, we just signed the best pitcher in baseball? Or the one or two, Jacob DeGrom would argue.
Yeah. No, I was excited about it. I knew that there was a chance, but I didn't know if he would actually come. I knew that we wanted him badly, you know, everything that I had heard from the people I know. And, you know, I was just kind of not nervous about it. I know we had a great team either way, but, you know, it was exciting. I mean, you see the number, and it's kind of eye-popping. But overall, just, you know, another great guy to add to the room. And we're excited.
Gio, how much are you going to miss Didi?
A lot. Didi is fun. I love to have Didi always, like, next to me in the locker room, always talking. He's a good guy, trying to always smile, trying to keep the group together, and it's fun to play with Didi.
Do you believe that Gleyber could take over defensively at short? We know how well he plays at second. Can he do the job at short?
Yeah, for sure, 100%. He grew up at a shortstop, and I think he's going to do a really good job.
Adam, a lot of rumors swirling around Nolan Arenado. We see him from afar. You got a chance to play with him. Just describe what kind of player he's like.
I mean, you know, he's one of the best players in the game. Top five, easy. He's unbelievable defender, like, you know, Hall of Fame defender. And he's a great hitter, too. And he gets better with guys in scoring position. He gives tougher at-bats. He's like a baseball rat. Like, his personality is just obsessive, really, really hardworking. And that's kind of like how he is. He's maybe not the best athlete of like those guys that are in the top five, but right, probably the hardest working and just most his willpower is really strong.
Now, we had heard so much after you signed with the Yankees last year that you had that laboratory, pitching laboratory, but that laboratory is no longer there. Was there a laboratory somewhere else this winter where you worked on stuff?
Yankee Stadium.
Okay.
So
it's a bigger lab.
Yeah, they set it up nice for me, and, you know, I was able to do some stuff there that I wasn't able to do in my own place, like, you know, shower. So it was nice. They took good care of me.
So you were there a lot during the winter?
Yeah, quite a bit.
Gio, how did you handle New York with all the stardom, all the fame that you got rushed to you in the biggest city in North America? How did you handle becoming a star?
I mean, it's fun to play for New York. I love the city, I love the fan, the way they care the game. That's made me, like, going to the game, like, really, really excited and play for win.
Adam, is this team so good that it's World Series or bust?
I think that's always the goal with the Yankees. You know, I know I've only been for 1 year, but I know even prior to that, team went deep into the playoffs. So that's the next step. Got to get to the World Series in our minds. I mean, there's a lot to take care of before that. But ultimately, yeah, I think World Series are bust.
Now, you grew up a Yankee career in Colorado. Was it different playing for the Yankees? Was there a different feeling?
I did think I did a good job of not paying attention to the external stuff that I was all about when I was younger. You know, I mean, I know that there's a lot more coverage. I know what the Yankee fans expect. I was one of them, so I get it. But I did a good job of like kind of insulating myself from all of that. But I think organizationally, like, we know that what the goal is, and I think it's a little different than in Colorado. I think maybe in Colorado we were trying to develop, but also like hope for a miracle maybe, whereas with the Yankees it's kind of like we're expected to play well and to win every night.
Growing up a Yankee fan, the first time you put on those pinstripes, was it surreal? Did you sit there and take a look and go, wow, this really happened?
Yeah. I went in after I signed to the stadium to like take a new headshot, and they put on the jersey and it felt like heavy to me. You know, and I commented that, and some of the clubhouse guys said that, you know, it gets lighter, don't worry. Like, but it definitely felt heavy at first. I mean, I won't lie.
Well, it's interesting because it's not the same story as someone who gets drafted to the team they grew up dreaming of being on. So you had the experience in Colorado, but still, are there nerves the first time you walk out of the bullpen and, like, I'm pitching now at Yankee Stadium?
Yeah, I was nervous, anxious, all that, but they got me in there right away. I think I was the first guy to come in the game out of the pen in the season last year, so I was grateful for that. Just,
right,
like, rip the Band-Aid off, get in. And also, like, I felt like, I've pitched a long time now, and I know I'm actually good. So before, it would have been a lot more nerve-wracking when I didn't know my own ability, but I knew last year I was going to do fine.
Well, I noticed, you know, you were out in the dugout during Old Timers Day. Was there anybody that you met that you had wanted to meet, and was it kind of a cool feeling?
All the guys. I mean, I try to talk to them as much as possible, pretty much everybody, but, like, Bernie was my guy. He's a guy that, like, I'm kind of starstruck by when I see
really?
Him. Yeah, even more than Mariano or anybody, but for some reason, Bernie. So, you know, I try to be, like, kind of, I'm kind of coy around him, you know. I try to talk to him a little bit, but that type of thing.
How about you, Gio? I mean, you didn't dream of being a Yankee, but you're a Yankee. What was it like? Were those pinstripes heavy?
I mean, that's mean a lot for every player who played for the Yankees. Like, even the fans in Colombia, I don't even know, like, we got a lot of fans, a lot of Yankee fans in Colombia since I got to the Yankees, and that's made me feel like I gotta play good, we gotta win, and we gotta win that World Series.
Who was your, growing up, who was your favorite ball player?
A-Rod.
Yeah. Perfect. Have you gotten to spend some time with him now that you've...
Yeah, I spoke with him sometimes last year.
Do they get the YES Network in Venezuela?
Colombia,
I'm sorry. Nah. They don't?
No.
We got to get it for you.
For sure.
Yeah, the whole town will watch.
I'm kind of curious to see if they get it in Venezuela now.
Yeah.
So are people in Colombia able to watch you?
Yeah,
there's
for sure.
People can watch online and things like that.
They watch a lot of Yankee games.
And do you think that here, because there's a huge Colombian community in New York, in Queens in particular, do you think that the Colombians who live in New York know that you're a Yankee and are coming out to support you?
Yeah, for sure. I spent a couple of time in Queens last year, and they know, like, it's a Colombian player in the Yankees.
Well, Adam, you rooted for the Yankees. What other teams in New York did you root for?
Knicks. That's
sorry.
Tough.
Yeah. God bless you.
Giants, although I'm not really into football much. Mm-hmm. And then Islanders.
Okay.
Yeah. My dad's family's from Long Island, so.
Yeah, obviously, you root for the Islanders during a very, very tough time.
Yeah, for sure.
I was going to say, you're a young guy. You missed the good times.
Yeah, I did.
Well, the good times are coming again.
Yeah.
Well, I'll see you guys later at the dinner. I thank you for dropping by,
so
and obviously
much.
I'll see you both in Tampa.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you so much.
Cheers,
Adam Ottavino and Gio Urshela. So good stuff for those guys, and a lot expected from both of them. The Michael K. Show on 98.7 ESPN is brought to you by...